Aha, aha, aha. Listen. Bright lights, bright lights. Plenty women. Bottle out the bottle. So
before you go in.
Well, black people don't.
Check that thing out.
Real quick, Leroy just tweeted he got married because he wanted half. And because she got paid.
I know. That's why I'm getting married to Jay Davis.
What the heck?
Oh!
You want to split a 20? That's what you want to split.
That's why I'm marrying you yet.
Oh, ain't that all?
Wait for you to come up.
Track, what's happening, man? You want to chime in real quick?
My baby.
Your mic is on.
Your mic on.
Your mic sounds
loud.
My earphones? I can't hear no earphones.
Yeah, we can hear you, man.
Yo. Yo, I can't hear myself. But
yeah, it's cool. But, but what?
Yeah, shit, I'm married myself, and, you know, we known each other for, like, since high school and stuff like that. But it's all depends on individuality. You got to, you know, within yourself. It's all about how you think.
Right.
You know what I mean? You attract everything what you think.
If you're negative, your thoughts create your negative. Reality.
Right.
My
right.
So
it's good to find your soulmate, you know.
Right.
Like,
you,
do some stuff.
I think you are 100%.
That's for me.
Know your personnel. Shout out to my man, Chaz, man. Know who you dealing with.
Right.
Know everything. Like, that person, like, it's a such thing as connection. Stop marrying the chick because she got ass and tits.
Yes. That helps.
You know what I'm saying? Let's keep it real and real.
Mm-hmm.
Stop marrying niggas because they got that paper. We living in 2012. You can be paid today and broke today. Real talk. You know what I'm saying? I call it the Enron lifestyle. You know what I'm saying? You can be paid today, gone today.
Yeah.
Even the average drug dealer is gone. Is paid today, gone today. Fans is checking out the taps, boots, phones, and all that. So, women, stop checking for the materialism. Some of you women, wake up, man. You know what I mean? And let me add this. Men, stop marrying chicks for sex because you want some.
And let me say this. Men, stop marrying chicks when you don't want to be married.
Yes.
Because that's definitely contributing to the divorce rate.
Right.
Men and women, stop marrying people when you don't want to be married.
Did you hear DMX on that
Why
show?
Why is getting married and still having sex with other people?
DMX, him and his...
And your wife doesn't agree
his
with that.
His baby mama was on... They was on couples therapy, and he was like, what did he say? He was like, I'm going to fuck till my dick fall off. I can't help it.
Wow.
And he was like, I didn't even want to get married. I was like, Jesus Christ.
And that's why I don't understand people get married and they don't even want to. Just like, oh,
I mean,
I think it's
more. I mean, sex is a big
time.
Movement, but I mean, at the end of the day,
right.
There's more to life than getting pussy.
But see,
head helps.
Yeah, I know that self. That's why I said
that's
right.
It.
That's
see,
it.
All those things, all addictions, I just think so you don't have to deal with yourself. So once you deal with yourself, you'll know all those things are just small things to make life a little better. You won't need it and pursue it to your detriment. So it is definitely knowledge of self that creates all the love.
That's it. Know thyself.
That's what's up. So, what would you recommend? You got to get somebody. Do you recommend therapy before you get married, Twine?
Big time.
Man, I recommend, you know, both of you guys, you know, experience some type of, you know, relationship balance.
Like a threesome? Is that what you're saying?
Hey, man.
Oh,
man.
So, are you trying to say you don't want threesome, Twine Tracks?
Man, I'm married, Joe.
I mean, I'm just saying.
You know he a comedian.
He's like,
I gotta watch.
Don't do this to me.
He's a comedian. He'll slide it in on you. Don't let him.
I will slide it in. Hey, Laura, how you doing over there?
But they should see some therapy. But the right person who's, you know, you don't want anybody just giving you advice because they spirit gotta be right as well.
Mm-hmm.
So I mean, that's on that type.
That's
That's
it.
That's about it.
Yes, sir.
What's up. Miss Kennedy, what do you think about that?
What?
You agree with Jeff?
Which part?
All of it.
Pretty much.
Lori, when you going to get married one day?
No.
You never. Lori just said, fuck it. I don't like the numbers. See, this is the thing. Like, nah. Nah, it ain't going to happen.
I don't know. I'll be like this sometime.
I would get married.
You would next year?
Yeah.
Okay.
But I, of course, have to
find
a boyfriend first.
Yeah, that'll help the whole marriage process.
Man,
yeah.
What's the problem, Nick?
I don't have a problem. Nobody's good enough.
Damn.
That's another application.
God damn, oh, Nick.
My God. Oh, my, nobody's good enough. What you require?
They're fine good enough.
What's good enough?
First of all, they have to have a spiritual connection.
Yeah, that's very important.
That's dope.
Okay, and I have two sons, so first of all, that's one of the main things. I'm not trying to have guys all willy-nilly around my two kings, you know.
Doing that baby boy in the kitchen?
Yeah, that's not going to do it. So anyway, they're older now, though, so I don't have to have that same restriction I had because they're 18 and almost 12 now. But so that's one thing. And then I had a long-term relationship. It just burned. So after that, it just crashed and burned.
Oh, I thought you meant another burn.
It was 5 years. No, he was good. He's a good guy. He's still my friend. But it was like 5 years. So after that, I didn't think it was. I think rebounding is good in basketball, but not love. So ooh, I just took time.
No, rewind that back. Say that again.
That's a beautiful quote, Nikki G.
I think rebounding is good in basketball, but not love. So I took time. If I was with him for 5 years, I think it took at least half that time to get rid of him from my spirit and my time.
Wow.
So I needed 2.5 years in my book to at least just be with myself. And then I could, I can attract to me what I desire. But if I'm still missing him, then I'm going to attract somebody else like him and repeat that cycle. Wow.
Real quick, Leroy just tweeted that he read the Bible at least one time. And do you have benefits, Nikki?
Do I have benefits?
Yes, Leroy wants to know if you have benefits.
I do have benefits.
Leroy, she has benefits.
Do you?
Leroy does not have nothing.
Well, Leroy, another requirement is I already got, how they say people bring something to the table.
Uh-huh.
I want you to bring the tape.
Leroy, you heard it first.
Hey, you know how to fix the table shit.
Because I already got a house.
It got a stand.
I owns mine. So I'm going to need you to be doing the same thing. But don't get me wrong. I'm not against helping a brother.
Why?
I will help you get up. It's just like this, I won't go get the fish, but I might buy you a fishing pole and show you
Leroy
which
said
way to go.
He tries. You want to give him credit for trying? Leroy.
Yes, I do give credit for trying. Good job, King. Keep it up.
Keep trying.
Yeah.
Keep bagging the weed up, Leroy. You're going to make some of yourself.
Whoa. off air.
Nick, you. I like your theory on, making sure the man is on his job. But what are you bringing to the table?
What does Nikki G have to offer?
Nikki G is on her business. Okay. Nikki G owns everything she has. Mm-hmm. Steady buying more. Wow. I've done it all. Actually, I don't have any problem, contributing. Like I said, I had a guy who I thought I was going to like. Mm-hmm. And I had no problem. He was on hard times. I had no problem consistent. But a lot of women out here, in order to just be able to say they have a man, I'm willing to take care of them. I have two sons. I refuse to let them observe me take care of a grown man.
I know that's right. You better.
They will not think it's okay for you not to work. You don't work. You don't eat.
You better preach.
Oh, how y'all feel about that? Somebody tweeted this. How do you feel about a man who has kids? Doesn't take care of his kids, but take care of somebody else's kids.
That you are speaking of someone I know. Uh-huh. You might be talking about him.
No, I wasn't talking about him. I was talking about somebody else. I have another friend.
So anyway, they're entitled to do what they want. As far as I go, one of my son's father doesn't participate, and I feel like this.
Uh-huh.
He know he had a son. My son know he's his dad, and God knows. So that's between them three.
Damn, work it out.
Right. That's between him, his son, and God. So, my son is well taken care of, always been. He's 18, honor roll student, about to go out to college with scholarships and everything. He's on the chess team, he's on the robotics team, he's running it. So, apparently, that father wasn't needed.
That's what's up. Jeff, what do you feel about that, man?
Man, listen.
I'm not going to make anybody do what they want to do. Listen. I didn't take him to court or
nothing. Listen. I'm going to break it down, man. Being a father is a hard job, but you got to do it. Ain't no, you should, maybe you have to be a good father to your child, because if you don't be a father to your children, it's a lot of stuff that can happen.
This is my way to let you know that you're a bad father. All right, dads out there, if none of your kids have your last name, you probably a bad father.
Wow.
You're so stupid.
Hey.
Hey, that might be a good point.
Hey, it's true. If your kids call you by your first name, you're a bad father.
That's a problem.
If you don't get any Father's Day cards, And you got 12 kids?
Oh, shit.
Not even the handmade ones? Not even the ones like folded construction paper?
You gotta take care
paper?
Of your business.
But, shout out to the ladies who do let them see their fathers, their kids.
Yeah, I would never ever, I would never ever hinder.
Even if when times, like if you have issues.
I have nothing to do with it. You know what I'm saying? Right. That's what I used to tell. He used to like use an excuse when people would see him out. Like, you ain't take care of your kids? Because they couldn't believe it, right?
Mm-hmm.
And he was like, oh, that's Nikki, she's crazy. I'm like, even, okay, everybody know I'm cool, so they know that's just an excuse. But even if I am crazy, if I'm off my freaking rocker, what does that have to do with you and your son?
Take care of your business.
What does that have to do with your seed?
Take care of your business.
If I'm off the chain, out of my mind, what does that have to do with your seed?
That's right.
Do what you got to do to go around me to get to your seed.
Let me say this, too. To all you women using your kids as pawns.
That's wrong. That's and you're going to have to pay for that. That's karma.
That's
everything
wrong.
You put out there got to come back.
Please believe.
Depending on the circumstances.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm saying.
If he abusing or something.
Right. Then, I understand that. But if you're using your... I'm talking about those
yeah,
women
I know what you mean.
That,
know
for
what
example...
The pawn.
Let me set it up for you. You're going to have to fuck me in order to see your son.
Oh, you got a new girlfriend, Sal.
Yeah. You know, that ain't right.
It has nothing to do with
you. You got to give me $10,000 in order to see your kids.
Man,
that's
nothing to do
with it. What, you bribing? Man, that's not how we do it.
That's not a good look at all.
That's more than bogus.
It's not a good look.
Wow. So if anybody got some issues with their baby mama, baby daddy, call into the show. And if you got any... Questions about marriage.
And if you just want to say hi to Nikki G, the co-host holding it down for Harris and CB.
And CB.
And you got a wedding ring in your pocket. Go ahead and call up.
Oh,
what's the number?
Oh, and real quick, yeah, the number to call in is 708-261-2729.
Did y'all get that number?
708-261-2729. But and real, I want to give another shout out to Paris. I hope you get well. And, Gio, he just told me today that he had a little incident put him in the hospital.
Oh, no.
So I hope Gio gets better real soon, and I'm probably going
to
see him.
We're sending healing energy to you, Gio.
Well, we're going to take a quick break, and everybody tune in for more of the Jay Davis Show.
I hate love songs, but I'm writing one for you. What's up? This your girl, Jamisha Trice, and I'm listening to The Jay Davis Show every Saturday from 2 to 4. Jay Davis, you nasty.